is ABC25 Weekend.
Okay, now that that's out of the way.
Now, some of last week's deadly tornadoes were the direct result of the El Nino weather pattern.
Coming up on my final segment of Florida Storm Theory, El Nino gets home. How El Nino affects us here in Florida.
That's coming up next.
Is that an airplane on your head?
Things pretty wild. Burned to the ground. Yesterday, a Rosewood survivor shared her story with students at FCCJ. 79-year-old Mary Hall Daniels was a young girl when Rosewood went up in flames. Angry mobs set the Florida town on fire after a white woman.
On the First Alert Live Doppler radar, no signs of them in the city. And on a 300-mile radius of Jacksonville, same story. Now, we may have a few problems with Santa getting here. Yeah, looking at right 11 o'clock this evening for more updates on Santa.
All right, Stacy, moonlighting is one of Santa's elves?
I think so.
To help you beat the blues. A warning before this next story, if you like chocolate, then you're not going to want to watch this story. Our scripts are messed up, so let me try this one. While we're on the subject of food, how about some pizza? Can you guess how...
Where'd you get the airplane?
From the opening last night.
Oh, the opening? So that's an airplane.
Number seven, that's funny. Two-time national cross-country champion, Ruben Reno, Fayetteville, Arkansas.
Tale of a fateful trip that started from this tropic boy.
Aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailing man, the skipper brave and sure. Five passengers set sail that
day for a three-hour tour.
Green Acres is the place to be. Farm living is the life for me.
I just adore a penthouse view.
Follow and love you, but give me Park Avenue.
The chores.
The stores.
Fresh air.
Times Square.
You are my wife.
Goodbye, city life.
Cause you are.
Kidnapped one this morning as he waited for his ride to school. The boys are safe now, and the alleged kidnapper behind bars. Have you seen this man? Police sure hope you have. He's wanted for bank robbery. And another neighborhood is getting special attention from the mayor. We'll show you.
Ed Eyestone is the former winner of the Game Never Run and appears to be Eyestone by Singlet.
So what kind of airplane is that?
Number four, Watercooler.
Southwest Airlines.
1996 Olympian. Number 20 is Steve Placencia.
Of us to employ mandatory water restrictions. ABC25's Emery Ouellette tells us what it means for homeowners.
That's right, Bruce. Those mandatory restrictions are actually in
effect. His successor, Governor Buddy McKay, says he believes the child's legacy is so much more.
It's very important to us. It was
now with Taylor Phillips and see how the morning commute's going. Good morning, Taylor.
Good morning, Renee.
Well, obviously, Taylor is a little bit confused there. I'm not Renee, but she'll be back to give us a traffic forecast here in just a minute.
Now, about 30%. So this is the time for you to get out anytime now until 7 p.m. That's open all day. And we should know some of those.
Hey, Bob, how's it going?
Fuck off.
All righty.
Company's latest contract offer. Plus, the shrimp festival going on in Fernandina Beach. Fernandina Bridge.
From the traffic center on the South Bank, I'm Taylor Phillips for ABC 25 Today. Back to you, Jan.
Thank you, Taylor, a terrible accident on the west side.
Same table at the same time. In American Beach, I'm Rob Harleston, ABC 25 News.
Sir, 40-year-old. 24 is Brian Quest from New York City.
You have to blow that thing up?
22 is Bob.
Oh, man, look at that guy.
Babe, I love you.